Hi everyone, welcome back to my kitchen and channel. Today I'm going to show you how I make my butter chicken. And here I have some oil that I'm going to add to the pot. I've added my oil to the pot. And I'm also going to add some butter here. I'm using Kerrygold butter that I'm going to cut and add a little piece to that oil. Right, just a little piece to flavor up that oil. Butter chicken is a very flavorful, delicious dish, and you can eat potatoes with it, curry potatoes. I'm giving it my Trini twist today, and you see how nice that butter melted out in that oil. This is the seasoning mix that I'll be using. 2-pack comes in this box. And now that that has melted out, my chicken pieces will go in. I'm using chicken on the bone. It's one chicken cut up into smaller pieces. You can use boneless chicken to do this, boneless chicken breast or thighs. And we're going to let this fry up here until it's a little on the golden brown side, and then we would layer up this chicken pieces. Have your heat on high for this process. So let that get cooking and I'll show you the next steps. In the meantime, I'm going to show you that curry potato that will go with this butter chicken. So in a pot here I have oil that's heating. I'm going to add in my onion. And my pimento peppers and my half a cut scotch bonnet pepper goes in. Let that fry up and the chicken is coming along nicely. This is just going to be basic curry potatoes. In goes my curry powder. 2 tablespoons of curry powder goes in. And 1 teaspoon of saffron. And a half. I also have jeera. A sprinkle of that jeera goes in. And here I have some water. Hot water goes in. To make that curry paste. We're gonna let that fry up until that curry cooks. Make sure the curry is all melted out when you add in that water. And now we're going to let that cook up a little bit before adding in our potatoes. I have my potatoes already peeled and washed and soaked in water here, just to drain all that water to go into the air, so that curry paste is looking really good now. In goes my potato aloo. I am adding 1 teaspoon of salt goes in. And I have here my green seasoning goes in. 1 big tablespoon of seasoning goes in. Give this a mix now. Water, as we say here, turn your pot. So I'm switching back to my spatula. And you see how that potato is well seasoned with that green seasoning. Green seasoning is a basic mix that we make here in the Caribbean. It consists of regular bandanya, shadow benny, or you can use cilantro, garlic, pimento peppers, hot scotch bonnet peppers, and if you want, you can add whatever else seasoning you like. It includes celery, chives, parsley, fine thyme, whatever you like, right, you can put it in. And I'm going to let this fry up for a bit before adding in that rest of water to make that liquid, that sauce. Back to our chicken here, it's cooking here. So once it turns to that lightly colored brown or golden colored brown, we will start layering up our rest of ingredients for this delicious, flavorful dish. See how it's getting brown. Now this chicken is seasoned with that same green seasoning, that regular green seasoning, together with some black pepper and a little salt, because that seasoning in the pack, that butter chicken seasoning, is already salted, so we don't want to get it too salty, you know. So let me give you a closer look to that chicken here. You see how it's getting nice and brown? That is what we were looking for. And the potatoes are coming along nicely. See? So I'm going to add my liquid to that. Fried up really nice. And in goes our liquid to make that sauce or gravy to eat with that naan that is going to go with that butter chicken. So we're going to cover this potato aloo pot on medium heat and let it cook. Let it do its magic. And let it cook. There's a hole in the cover, so the steam will come through there. just add this in a short space of time. So back to the chicken here. The chicken is coming along beautifully. The oil is separating out. I'm not going to leave all this oil. I'm going to drain it out before I start doing that next layering of the rest of ingredients, because that's going to be just too much of oil and butter to intake. So what you're going to do is that same plate you have at the side, you're going to take all those chicken pieces and we're going to put it in a plate and drain off that oil into another bowl. And just add like 2 tablespoons back into the pot and continue layering it. So this has to go for the next 10 minutes. So the chicken has a nice color for me here. See how there's the golden brown color to it? So this is the first step to this. So now I'm going to take out all the pieces and drain off that oil, and I'll show you the next steps. Right, we have drained it out, and that same oil and butter mixture, what we're going to do is just add a little bit back to the pot. Right, just 1 spoon is what we need. I do not want to use all of that oil and butter in this dish. And add back our pieces of chicken. You see how beautifully it is? With that color, that light golden color, that is what we are looking for. Right, add back that there. And I'm just switching my plate. Right, just let it fry down a little for a minute again. And now we will start to add our rest of ingredients to this butter chicken dish. We're going to add 1 pack of our seasoning mix. One full pack goes in. Is that enough? This is where the flavoring will come in. You see how the color changed? And now we will add our tomato paste. So I'm going in with 2 spoons of that. And my fresh tomatoes goes in. I like that texture of that fresh tomatoes rather than just the tomato paste. And it's just 4 tomatoes. You can puree it up in your mini chopper or cut it up fine. And we're just gonna cook this for about 5 minutes before adding in our next set of ingredients. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna cover it to heat through. Let's check this. See how beautiful that red color is. Now this is optional. I have here finely diced onions and garlic, but I like to use my onions and my garlic in my meats. So in goes that. This is gonna fry up here. It also gives it a nice texture to that sauce or gravy when it's finished, because we don't want a thin sauce, we want a thickish sauce, because we already have that potatoes to go with that, to eat with the naan. So we're just gonna cover it up to fry up a little bit before adding in our milk and yogurt. And now we will add our milk. This is 1 1/4 cups milk. We'll give this a turn. After adding the milk, it has to cook for another 5 to 10 minutes. And after it has finished, within that time, I will add that yogurt. If you have heavy cream or cooking cream, you can add that instead of the yogurt. So let's let this start back to cook and I'll show you the next step. Now that it has cooked and softened up, what we're going to do is take a potato masher and gently mash it. Right, this is just to help it cook through fast and to make that nice texture of that sauce or that gravy. And you will know how you want it. If you want it on the more drier side or thick side, you can leave it. Or if you want it on the thin side, you can leave it. Right? And it also gives it a little chunk, leaves a little chunks of potato to it. See? All hasn't mashed out, but it will continue cooking and easily slowly melt out, and you will know what consistency you want it at. Taste the salt and adjust the suit. Cover back and let it continue cooking until it has cooked through. Let's check the chicken. Right, and you see after adding in that milk, that consistency that you have here with that nice color, that nice red color. Now you can make this how spicy you want it. Extra spice, you just have to add your scotch bonnet pepper. But that spice and that seasoning mix, it has already have its own flavorings. So I would suggest you taste it and adjust your pepper to suit. Right, now I will add my yogurt, or if you have cream, you can add cream instead of that yogurt. Right, this yogurt is just to balance out that flavor from that tomato paste, so it will not be on the so sour side. It will have a nice taste. Right, and we're going to give this another 5 minutes to cook. just for that yogurt to heat through. What do you think about the color? This is butter chicken with a Trini twist, right? Simple and easy to make. It's a one pot dish. As I said, you can use boneless meat if you want, chicken breasts or thighs, if you don't like the bone in the chicken. But I find it gives it a more chicken flavor when it has the bones. Right, so I'm going to cover this and let it through again for another 5 minutes. And I'll show you when it's done what it looks like. This is the final step to the finishing butter chicken. It is coming along really nicely. The scent of it is really, really nice here in my kitchen. I'm going to leave it uncovered now and let it dry down a little bit. Now, if you're using butter chicken and naan alone, this is the consistency you're going to leave it. Right, I'm just going to give it like a 2 minutes again uncovered and turn off that stove and cover it, because when it cools down it will get thicker up on you. Right, let me just get a spoon and show you that consistency. You see that consistency of that gravy or that sauce? That's just perfect to eat with that naan as it is, right? And the chicken pieces is really, really nice. Okay, and my final dish to go with this is that curry potato. I am going to show you it. You see how that consistency is really nice after mashing it with our potato masher. It has a really nice consistency. And that's it. This is going to be eaten with that naan. I will do that video separately. I just wanted to give you guys an idea what you can eat together with that and that curry potato, right? If you want chana and potato, all you had to do was add your chana or chickpea to the potato when you add it in and let it cook, and you will get chana and aloo, or chana and potatoes, or chickpea and potato. Right, so the both things has a really nice consistency. Right, I am turning off my stove, and my last finished touches for that is some grind jeera again, just a very little, and it gives that whole dish, that curry potato dish, a really nice flavor to the end. Right, if you just want vegetarian, then you can use your curry potatoes with your naan and leave out the meat. But I like doing my videos to show you and include each dish that I'm having with that meal today, on that day. Right, the stove is turned off. I will cover it back. Before I go, this is the seasoning mix that I used again. It comes in 2 packs, and it's just 1 pack per meal. Right, if you don't get access to it, it also has the Shan brand to it, and I believe they carry it here in the supermarket, either this brand or the Shan brand. Right, and this is the method and the way of doing it. Just I changed it up a bit and added my Trini twist to it in my way, and that's it. Right, simple butter chicken. Look at it in the box, and look at mine. Right, so as you can see, it's really simple to put together. This has a really nice consistency for me here. I am going to turn off that stove as well, because it will cool off as it gets cool down. It will thicken up, right? And that's it.